Baseball's taught me to appreciate my parents, my mentors, and my fellow teammates. That's something I learned in elementary, middle, and high school.
Ken Higashiguchi is 6 years old and lives with his mother and father in Nara, Japan, a nation committed to having a fully literate society. Nearly every child in Japan goes to school. And today, like Ken, thousands of six-year-olds are preparing to attend their opening day ceremony.
I have to wear this for a whole hour? It's embarrassing.
We want to give Ken a lot of chances, a lot of opportunities. The most important thing is for Ken to be happy for his life.
Today, Ken joins the ranks of students who follow a long, well-planned journey through one of the most successful school systems in the world, and one of the most demanding. Unlike his counterparts in much of the world, Ken is well prepared for first grade. He has been in state-funded daycare since the age of one.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Along with many Japanese school children, Ken attends private after-school classes known as juku schools.
Very good.
Ken's parents are pushing him to get the best education possible. But the hours are long and the expectations are high. Both of Ken's parents work full-time, but they devote their weekends to their only child, often doing what Ken, now nine, loves most, playing baseball.
So far, he likes everything, including sports, studying, and playing around. I think he feels that if he makes the effort, he can do anything.
Ken is now in third grade at Saho Elementary School and often arrives early to play with his friends. After decades of imposing stringent standards and an 11-month school year, Japan has dropped Saturdays from the school week. But one thing hasn't changed: teaching teamwork, the hallmark of the Japanese workforce.
I have 30 students, and I'd like for them to do something together continuously. That's how we started skipping rope together once a week for a year, back in April.
Today, their goal is to achieve 1,000 consecutive jumps.
You guys jumped 300 more than the time before. Do you know why we were doing this?
When I grow up, I want to be a professional baseball player or a school teacher. When I started, I didn't know how to catch or throw or hold the bat.
At 12, Ken is finishing sixth grade and trying his best to balance his love of sports and his need to study.
He reads in the paper and the news about other kids in other countries. He thinks going to school and playing with friends are a given, and having meals every day is a given. I think that at a conscious level, he understands the reality that there are kids his age who can't go to school and have to work in order to survive. I just don't know how much he understands that emotionally. I think that's what he'll have to learn as he gets older.
Ken is 18 years old and has never missed a single day of school.
School is a place where you can really expand your knowledge. And where you can also meet new people.
Ken is about to graduate from high school and start college, carrying on a tradition of discipline and teamwork which he mastered as captain of his baseball team. Today, the whole school community is here for Ken's last game.
Playing baseball has taught me the importance of motivating the team, not only by what I say, but also by what I do.
Ken's team loses the game. His tireless focus on training makes the loss especially difficult.
We really wanted to win, so I tried hard to pull the team together. But still, it seems it wasn't enough. Next year, the team will continue to do their best.
Whenever he was having a hard time, I saw him gather the strength to move on. And then I was able to gain that strength too.
Learning not to run away from difficult situations has definitely been my biggest achievement.
Ken also learned lessons from the tragedy that struck Japan in 2011. The earthquake and tsunami that claimed 16,000 lives. Ken traveled with his mother the 400 miles from his home to the damaged region. Students at Ken's school gathered funds for the effort and sent care packages.
I was in student government for 2 years. During that time, the great earthquake happened. We raised money and came up with new ideas. That's how we contributed.
He doesn't compromise and doesn't let himself off easy. I believe this is the man he is trying to become.
I think we created a good environment for him to be able to succeed at what he wanted to do.
Ken is now off to college near his home. He will study to be a physical education teacher and will try to bring the lessons of teamwork and concern for others to future generations.
I think the first step is to put our words into actions. And then we can have a positive impact on those around us. That's the kind of person I want to be.